Good afternoon, one and all. Today we will see the one of the microwave T junction, E-plane T junction. Myself, Piyusha Shetgar. These are the learning outcomes for this session. At the end of this session, students will be able to derive the scattering matrix for E-plane T junction, and they will be able to apply the properties of S matrix to A-plane T junction. These are the contents. So first we will see what is the microwave T junction. Microwave T junction is an interconnection of the three waveguides in the form of the English alphabet T. Therefore it is known as the microwave T junction. So there are several types of the T junctions: H-plane T-junction, E-plane T-junction, and the combination of E-plane T-junction and H-plane T-junction is also known as EH-plane T-junction or magic T-junction. So the first figure shows E-plane T-junction, where the side arm is connected to the wider portion of the main waveguide, whereas in H-plane T-junction, the side arm is connected to the narrower portion of the main waveguide. It is also known as the H-arm. And the combination of both E-plane T-junction and the H-plane T-junction is nothing but the hybrid plane T-junction or magic T-junction. Now we will see the details of this E-plane T-junction. As you know that the side arm is connected to this slot, is connected cut along the broader dimension of a long waveguide, and a side arm is attached as shown in this figure. These are having the three ports, port 1, 2 and port 3. Port 1 and port 2 are the collinear arms, and port 3 is also known as the E arm. In E-plane T-junction, these are the inputs are applied to port 3. You can apply the input to port 3, port 1 or port 2. Here, when the input is applied to port 3, the outputs at port 1 and port 2 will have the phase shift of 180 degree. Since the electric field line change their direction when they come out of the port 1 and 2, it is called as E-plane T-junction. E-plane T is also known as the voltage or series junction symmetrical about the central arm. As shown in this figure, you can observe that if the input is applied to port 3, whatever are the direction of the output at port 1 and the direction of the output at port 2 are out of phase with each other. Now we will see the calculation of the S parameters. As this port, this matrix which having this three port junction, the scattering matrix is considered is of the order of 3 by 3. The properties of E plane T can be defined by its S matrix. Determination of S parameters by applying properties of the S matrix. Now consider the S matrix which having these coefficients, and the S matrix is the order of 3 by 3 since it having the three ports. Before going to start the calculation, you can pause video here and you can write down the properties of the S matrix. So you can write the properties such as symmetrical property, unitary property and the other properties. Now we'll see the calculation of S parameter stepwise. Consider the step 1. Since the outputs at port 1 and port 2 are out of phase by 180 degree with an input at port 3, the scattering coefficients S13 and S23 must be out of phase. Meaning of this S13 as input is applied to port 3 and you are taking the output at port 1, whereas S23 means input is applied to port 3 and you are taking the output at port 2. Since these are out of phase with each other, S23 can be written as negative of S13. Now use the second property of the S matrix, symmetry property, as Sij equal to Sji. Since the number of columns equal to the number of rows, you can write these three conditions for this: S12 equal to S21, S13 equal to S31, S23 equal to S32, and from equation 1, S23 equal to minus of S13. Therefore, you can add this minus of S13 for the equation number 2. Next is, since port 3 is perfectly matched to the junction, that is, there is no any mismatching between the junction and the source, that is, there is no any reflection to the port 3, thus you can write S33 equal to 0. Using these values, equation 1, 2 and 3 in the above matrix, you can rewrite this matrix as shown in this equation number 4. Thus, we are getting the 4 unknown values S11, S12, S13 and S22. So, you can find these all values and you can put all these values in this equation to calculate the S matrix for the E-plane T-junction. Now, for this calculation, consider the next property, unitary property, that is, S matrix is multiplied with the complex conjugate of the S matrix equating to the identity matrix. Thus, this is the S matrix S11, 12, 13, and take the complex conjugate of this matrix multiplied with this matrix. Thus, you are getting the identity matrix, or it is the unit matrix. Now, multiplying this, the combination R1 is multiplying with the C1, thus you are getting these equations 5, 6, 7, 8. From the first equation, S11 square plus S12 square plus S13 square is equal to 1. And R2, C2 combination is S12 square plus S22 square plus S13 square equal to 1. Now, from equation 5 and 6, if you are comparing these two equations, these S11 and S22 are also equal, as S13 and S12 is equal. And therefore, from equation number 5 and 6, you can write the equation number 9 as S11 equal to S22. From equation 7, you can make it twice of S13 square is equal to 1. Thus, you are getting the value of S13 parameter, that is, input is applied to port 3 and you are taking the output out of the port 1 equal to 1 by root 2. Similarly, from equation 8, take S13 as a common and the complex conjugate of S11 minus complex conjugate of S12 equal to 0. From equation 10, you can observe that S13 is never equal to 0 because the calculated value for S13 equal to 1 by root 2, and therefore S13 is not equal to 0, thus you can equate this bracket is equal to 0. So from this, you can getting the equation S11 equal to S12, or S12 equal to S22 equal to S11. Now, using all these values in equation number 5 to calculate the value of S11 parameter, thus by putting all these values in this equation, by solving this equation, you are getting the value of S11 as 1 by 2. Now, from equation 11, S12 equal to minus of S11, as you know, S12 equal to 1/2, thus S22 is also becomes equal to 1 by 2. Now, substitute all these 4 unknown values in the above matrix equation number 4. Thus, you are getting this matrix, S matrix. It is also known as the scattering matrix for E-plane T-junction. Now, to calculate the output values, consider the output matrix B. This matrix is the column matrix B. It is also known as the output matrix, is equal to scattering matrix multiplied with the column matrix which having these inputs. Now, B1, B2, B3 are the outputs taken out of the port 1, 2 and 3. equal to whatever is the scattering matrix you're getting, then it is multiplied with the number of inputs A1, A2, A3 are applied to port 1, 2 and 3. Now by solving this matrix, you're getting these equations as shown by equation number 15, 16 and 17. So B1 equal to 1 by 2 A1 plus 1 by 2 A2 plus 1 by root 2 A3. B2 equal to 1 by 2 A1 plus 1 by 2 A2 minus 1 by root 2 A3. And B3 equal to 1 by root 2 A1 minus 1 by root 2 A2. Now to find out the outputs at different ports, consider the different cases. So consider the case 1. In case 1, input is given at port 3, that is, input is applied to the port 3 and the no input is at port 1 and port 2, that is A1 and A2 equal to 0 and A3 is not equal to 0. By putting these conditions in the above equation 15, 16 and 17, you are getting the value of the output B1, B2 and B3. An input at port 3 equally divides between the port 1 and port 2 from this B1 and B2, but these two are 180 degree out of phase with each other. Hence, E plane T acts as a 3 dB splitter. Consider the case 2. If A1, A2 equal to A, that is the same input is applied to port 1 and port 2, and A3 is equal to 0. Thus, you are getting the values of the output B1, B2, B3 as shown in this equation. Thus, if the equal input is applied to port 1 and port 2, there is no any output at port 3. That is, B3 is equal to 0. Case 3, if A1 is not equal to 0 and A2 and A3 are equal to 0, then you are getting this equation B1 and B2 which having the same value, and B3 is negative of A1 by root 2 value. Thus, you can find out the output for the different ports by applying the different cases. These are the references for this session. Thank you.